A child that is being read to in the early years turns out to be a very smart, intelligent and creative kid later on in their educated years. Hi, this is Gomati from the Little Story Station. Welcome to another episode of Read Along series with me. Today we are going to have a very interesting story from Africa. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please like, share and subscribe, and let's get into our story today. How are you today? This is your own Gomati auntie. Today, like I said earlier, we are going to have a story from Africa. Yes, how many of you have friends, like a very, very close friend for whom you, try to pack lunch or try to grab a snack or two, when you leave from home? Well, today in our story, there is a girl who does just that, and let's see what happens. Okay? Handa's Surprise by Eileen Brown. Handa put 7 delicious fruits in a basket for her friend Akio. She will be surprised, thought Handa, as she set off for Akio's village. I wonder which fruit she liked best. Will she like the soft yellow banana? Or the sweet smelling guava? Will she like the round juicy orange? Or the ripe red mango? Will she like the spiky leaved pineapple? The creamy green avocado? Or the tangy purple passion fruit? Which fruit will Akio like best? Hello, Akio, say Handa. I've brought you a surprise. Tangerines, said Akio. My favorite fruit. Tangerines, said Handa. That is a surprise. End of story. Hope you like this story. The painting in the book is very, very beautiful, isn't it? I had a feeling that I was in the forest of Africa when the first time I read the story. This is one of my favorite books, and another favorite book of my child as well. Hope you loved reading this story with me today. In the activity time today, shall we try to draw this cover picture where Handa carries the basket of fruits for her friend Akio? Alright, let's jump into the activity time today.
Hi Chico! Hi Pico! What are we drawing today?
We are drawing Handa and her fruit basket.
Ah, that will be very, very interesting. What do we need to get started?
A paper
and a pen.
That's right.
Let's get started.
So let's first get on to drawing Handa's basket. Onto the basket, a little bit of hay. Could be just random strokes here and there. And first let me draw the avocado and the plum, a guava, red mango, What does that? That's right. Pineapple. You could, for the pineapple, you could just do this and cross them off like that. That should do your pineapple. And lastly, another fruit with a couple of leaves there. That's it. That's her fruit basket. Now down to drawing Honda. Now let's start right where the avocado's center is. And go on. Just draw curves. And that. Now that's her face. Let us finish it off on the other side, and pretty soon it will get into shape, don't worry. Yeah, and that's her dress. Now on to her face. Let's draw her eyes very, very close to the basket. And for that, you just draw a curve, and that, and that. That's it. And that's her eyes. And that's her nose. And that is her lips. You connect the lips like that. There you go. That's Honda's face. And now we'll draw her ears. Her ears should be very, very close to the basket, and like so. That should do it. And now she's from Africa, isn't it? So she has some very interesting braids on her hair. Draw some braids here and there, and we should be good. And you could just do dots for her hair and stop it near the ears. Well, that's Honda from Honda's Surprise. Hope you guys enjoyed drawing Honda with me today. Until next time, take care.
Hi, welcome to today's Parents Corner. In today's episode, I'm going to share a tip that most parents ask me. I heard a lot of parents ask me, well, I get it. We understand that we should read to our children, but where do we find all the books? How many books do we buy? It's going to cost a fortune. Well, don't worry about that. I would like to share that, you know, we do not buy new books at all. Or rather, about 10 to 20% of our library is new books. The rest of it is all, yes, you guessed it right. It's used, pre-owned, pre-loved books. So every time there is a book fair or a book show, we go and look out for the used books, and that's how his library is about 300-400 books at 6 years old, and we do not spend too much money on it. I'm talking about books under 100 rupees. This I'm talking about in India, and I know places like the US or the UK, there are thrift shops and flea markets where you get books for very, very cheap, for in the place where you can buy one new book, you could buy about 4 to 5 used books. That's how you don't have to worry about shelling out a lot of money on these books. Hope you liked this tip today. If you did, please like, share and subscribe, and click on the bell icon down below so you get a notification every time I upload a new video. Now until next time, keep reading and spread the joy of reading. Take care, and this is bye from Gomati from the Little Story Station. Tata.